You must review the Steam controller.
The Steam controller?
It's taken too long, the time is now.
When people ask, you give them what they asked for.
Feel its power in your hands.
Show off its features.
Is it worthy of mere mortals? Do it.
Do it.
Do it.
Do it.
Do it.
The Steam controller is kind of a strange beast. Developed by Valve, the company responsible for Half-Life, Portal, and the extremely popular PC gaming marketplace, Steam, the Steam controller was part of their push to give computers a spot in your living room. I've already touched on the Steam Link, a device that allows you to access your PC from any room in your house, but I've refrained from sharing my thoughts on its companion, this controller. One reason for this is that it's a tough sell. You could probably get more enjoyment from the Steam Link by using an Xbox controller and a wireless mouse and keyboard. The Steam controller aims to be a jack of all trades, whether a game features controller support or not. You can use profiles which attempt to make everything controller friendly. It feels pretty solid in the hands, with a layout that is familiar to most gamers. The D-pad and right analog stick have been replaced with two trackpads. The one on the right most commonly simulates a trackball, and sliding your thumb on it offers a haptic feedback not unlike Nintendo's own Joy-Con controllers. You get a real sense of physicality that is very impressive, and moving it around is almost as seamless as a mouse. The D-pad isn't quite as useful. While it has divots to help you get a feel for what direction you're pushing, there's not enough precision to play even the most basic games properly with it. I typically map the directions for simple tasks like selecting items or using a flashlight. The analog stick is great, and paired with the traditional face buttons, most first-time users will probably lean on them out of familiarity. There are six sets of L and R buttons, with two on the very back of the controller. A switch on the bottom reveals the battery compartment. Two AA batteries promise to deliver up to 80 hours of use before needing to be replaced. The Steam button in the middle powers it up and will play back a selected startup sound. It will also bring up the overlay menu so that you can configure your controls or exit a game. Going into big picture mode, the Steam controller is easy enough to navigate with, and when you select a game, there's an option to customize your keys. Most likely, there's a default configuration that will register the Steam controller as an X input device. If not, it's easy to search for recommended templates or ones created by the community, but if there's nothing available, there's several general key maps. My suggestion is the WASD plus mouse template, and it's easy to fine-tune anything else that may be missing. Back to the D-pad, you can choose how inputs are registered, whether by pressing a direction down or by simply gliding your thumb around it. Still, I strongly recommend using the analog stick when precise timing is needed. When navigating outside of Steam, the right trackpad controls the mouse cursor. The triggers act as the left and right mouse buttons, and clicking the analog stick brings up a keyboard, where typing is accomplished in a similar manner as the DualShock 4 touchpad. Resting your thumbs on both pads allows you to hover over the QWERTY keys, and pressing down on them acts as a key press. It's not particularly useful for complex tasks, but the Steam controller enables you to pull up a website, access your folders, or select a file relatively easily. I have to say, one of my favorite features is something I didn't even know about until after months of use. Did you know the Steam controller has a built-in gyroscope? It sounds silly, but you can tilt the controller like a steering wheel, or use it to look around in your favorite game. I don't use it much, but it's a very welcome feature and surprisingly accurate. Valve is constantly tweaking the software for this peripheral, and their continuous support for it has made the Steam controller a more viable option compared to when it launched. I don't exactly feel that they've reinvented the wheel here, and the Steam controller is not for everyone out there. Some people love it and others hate it. I'm somewhere in between, honestly. I can appreciate all that Valve is trying to accomplish, and I'm happy to have one on my coffee table, but I can only recommend the Steam controller for those who are curious to play games a bit differently. If you're dedicated to your mouse and keyboard or controller of choice, it's probably not going to win you over. I received mine as part of a bundle with the Steam Link for less than $50, but I wouldn't have paid full price for it. Still, we shouldn't shun things just because they don't fit the typical standard. Remember when each console featured its own iconic gamepad? Well, almost all modern controllers play it safe and share the same general layout. If you miss those one-of-a-kind abominations, raise your freak flag high and pick one up. What do you guys think about the Steam Controller? Have you ever used one, or are you planning on picking one up? Let me know your thoughts and more in the comments. Like or subscribe if you'd like to support me. And as always, I'm thankful for your feedback and suggestions. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.